Hello students, we are going to start our next topic, that is input and output devices. In this chapter we have further subtopics: input devices and their uses, direct data entry and associated devices, output devices and their uses. In this video we will discuss about input devices and their uses. Input devices are the devices that are used to input data and instructions into the computer. We need input devices to give instructions to the computer, then we need a processor to do processing, output devices to give the display to get the result, and storage devices to store our data. We will discuss some input devices. Basically, there are further two categories of input devices. One is manual input devices that are used by people to enter data by themselves. For example, keyboard, we enter data by ourselves. Second is direct data entry devices which enable data to be entered directly. For example, barcode reader, we just enter the data directly, no need to enter manually. Let's discuss some manual input devices one by one. First one is keyboard. Keyboards are used to enter fixed values. When you press the key, a number is sent to the computer to tell it which key you have pressed. For example, you press A, computer does not understand the meaning of A, so it will just decode it into the computer in an understandable language and send to the computer for further processing. There are further categories of keyboard: QWERTY keyboard, concept keyboard and numeric keypads. Let's discuss one by one. First one is QWERTY keyboard. Almost all the computers are supplied with a keyboard. A keyboard has a different range of number of keys, 101 to 104 or many other keys also available, so depending upon the model of the keyboard. The key on a keyboard are usually arranged in the same order. Look at this, QWERTY layout. So this is a layout, this is just like a typewriter layout. Okay, so just based on this layout, we call them QWERTY keyboards. Next is concept keyboard. A concept keyboard is a flat board which contains a grid of switches. You have some grid of switches. Each switch can be programmed to do whatever you want. An overlay image is placed on the top of the grid so that the user can tell what pressing on a different area switches will do. For example, this is a menu order, so if you will press this one, it means you want to have a burger. So there will be program behind that switch. These are known as concept keyboard. You just have an overlay image and background processing will be done automatically according to the program. Next is numeric keypad. Numeric keypad is used to enter numbers only. Where it can be used? It can be used in the ATMs to enter your PIN or enter the amount of money. It can be used in the phone to enter to dial the telephones. It is also used in the electronic point of sale. Terminals have numeric keyboards in case the barcode reader fails. If you do not have the barcode reader or if the barcode reader fails, you can enter data manually by using the numeric keyboard at the point of sale. Okay, that was the keyboard, that was our first device. Second device is pointing devices. Pointing devices, devices that are used to point or select something on the screen. Example of pointing devices: mouse, tracker ball, joystick, light pen. So these all are the examples of pointing devices that are used to point or select something on the screen. First one is mouse. Mouse is the most common pointing device. You have the mouse around a mat and a small cursor called a pointer follows your movement. So wherever you will move your mouse, the pointer will move accordingly. You can select option using icons or menus on the screen. It can also be used to draw onto the screen. These are particularly useful if your computer has graphical user interface. We have already discussed that we have two types of interface: command line and the graphical user interface. In command line, you only have the keyboard. All the commands you have to give by typing. But in graphical user interface, you have menus, icons, pointers. So you have to select something, you need a mouse over there. So these are the uses of mouse. Second pointing device is tracker ball, that is similar to the mouse. The only difference is the ball is at the top. So instead of rotating the mouse, you have to rotate the ball on the top by your finger. Okay, tracker ball is an alternatively to mouse. It works in the same way as mouse, except that the ball is on the top. Turning the ball with your hand moves the pointer on the screen. When you rotate your ball with your hand, the pointer on the screen will rotate accordingly. Tracker balls are used mainly when there is not enough space for the mouse. For example, you have limited space to move the mouse, so you need, with the portable computers, you may need the tracker ball. okay, but that is little bit tiring as compared to the mouse. Next pointed device is joystick. You can move a standard joystick in any one of 8 directions: front, back, forward. So the joystick tells the computer in which direction it is being pulled. It may also have several buttons which can be pressed to trigger some actions, such as firing a missile. Where it can be used in the video computer games, often controlled by the joystick. These are used in simulators to mimic actual controls. They can be used to control motorized wheelchairs. More difficult to control on the screen pointers. A joystick with other devices such as mice. For example, if you are using a mouse to move the mouse on the screen pointer, it will be easy. But if you are using a joystick to move the mouse, move the pointer, it will be different, difficult. Next pointing device is light pen. Light pen is special pen which you can point out any computer monitor. When the pen is pointed at the screen, the computer can work out where the pen is pointing. Just like this, you are doing the work, or you are selecting, or you are pointing with the help of this pen. Okay, light pen can be used to draw on the screen or to select options from the menus. You can even use to draw, or you can use to select options. These are extremely poor input devices. They are very inaccurate and tiring to use. So you cannot do use it for the long time. So it is very tiring, and it is mostly used with the CRT monitors. Okay, next input device we have discussed two: keyboard and the pointing devices. Next input device is remote control. A remote control is used to control the operation of other devices remotely by using infrared signals. So it can use to control the operations of other devices by using the infrared signals. Enable devices to be operated from any distance, which is useful for people with disabilities also. Used in home entertainment devices such as televisions, DVD players, recorders. Used in industrial applications also to remotely control the processes, stop and start the machinery with the remote. The signal between the control and the device can be easily blocked. If you put something in front of that, so the signal of the infrared can be blocked easily. Next input device is touch screen. It is display screen that is both an input and output device, because you are getting the information, you are giving the information as well as getting the information on the screen. So it works as an input and output device. It can be found on the personal computers, laptops, tablets and the smartphones. It can determine where on the screen the user has touched and send that information to the processor for further processing. There are two main types of touch screen: resistive and the capacitive. Let's compare these types. Resistive touchscreen, the visibility in indoor is very good in both resistive and capacitive touchscreen. But visibility in sunlight is not good for the resistive, but good for the capacitive touchscreen. Okay, touch sensitivity, light pressure is needed. It can touch can respond with the fingers, even with the gloves, and the stylus also. But in capacitive touchscreen, it cannot work with the gloved fingers or the stylus. Accuracy. It is accurate to at least display pixel, but this is accurate to within a few pixels. Resistive is affordable, capacitive is more expensive than resistive. It does not have the multi-touch functionality, it has the multi-touch functionality. It is vulnerable to scratches. Resistive is vulnerable to scratches, but capacitive is more resistant to casual scratches. So it is more durable. Okay, next input device is scanners. It shines a light at a drawing and can interpret the reflected light so that the image can be stored on the computer. Hard copy material can be changed into form that can be edited. If you have a hard copy document or any picture or any image, you can just scan it and convert it into the form that can be edited also. Scanners are often used for three different types of input. What type of input? One is images from the hard copy material. Simply, if you have a document even, you can just scan it and pick it and convert it into the image form. Second is OCR from the hard copy text. OCR means you can convert the text into the editable form. If you have a document, you are scanning it, but it is not converting it as an image format, but as a text format, so that you can edit by using any word processing document. Third one is OMR, optical mark reader, from specially prepared hard copy forms. Okay, OMR, optical mark reader, only for the special type of hard copies that you can scan by using the scanner. So these are the major uses of input. Next input device, these are the manual input devices. Next input device is digital camera. It takes picture using a series of sensors that are arranged in a grid. The more pixels that are used, the better the quality of the picture. Look at this, this is 10 pixel per inch, this is 20 pixel per inch. The more closely the dots will be, the more closely the pixel will be, the better will be the quality of your picture. Okay, so it depends upon the number of pixels per inch, how your quality of the picture is. Can be connected to a computer using a USB or a Wi-Fi also. The picture can seen immediately and can also be erased. It can be converted to the computer or any other device so that it can be edited also. Can be reused and can be edited by using different softwares. Next input device is webcam. Webcams are special category of video camera that have no storage capacity. In digital camera, you have the storage capacity, you can store your pictures. But in webcam, you don't have the storage capacity. But these are directly connected to your computer. Used to enable video conferencing to take place, allows people to keep in contact with each other without the need of travel. Particularly used for disabled or the elderly people, they have limited features and the picture is often of the poor quality as compared to your digital cameras. Next is microphone. It is used to allow a computer to convert sounds into data that it can handle. Basically, our sound is a physical quantity, so computer cannot understand. So we will send the instruction by using the microphone. It will then be converted into the form that the computer can understand, in the digital form. It can be used to add speech in the presentation also. It can be used to give instructions to the computer by using voice recognition. Next input device is sensors. Sensors can be used to measure physical quantities such as temperature, light, pressure. The measurement can then be stored for later use or used to control the devices such as heaters or fans. Sensors are used for monitoring and the control applications. There are a lot of different types of sensors, but most have something in common. So what is in common? It can measure some physical quantity. It have any value within the limits. It collects data automatically. So these are in common, but there are a lot of different types of sensors. Let's discuss few of them. Temperature sensor, what it detects? It detects the temperature, how cool or how hot the temperature is. Light or dark. Pressure sensor, to detect the pressure. For example, someone is standing on it, so it will detect the pressure. Moisture sensor, dampness or dryness. Water level sensor, how full or empty a container is. Movement sensor, what is the movement nearby going on right now. Proximity sensor, how close or far something is. Okay, so these are what it detects and these are the types of sensors. Now, where these type of sensors are used? For example, temperature sensor, it can be used in automatic washing machine. It can be used in central heating system, automatic greenhouse, cookers. Pressure sensor, it can be used in alarm systems, washing machines, robotics, environmental monitoring. Light sensor, it can also be used in greenhouse, in automatic doors also, alarm system also, street light control also. Sound sensor can also be used in the alarm system as well as in the voice recognition system. Humidity sensor, it can be used in the greenhouse, environmental monitoring, agriculture factories, so to detect the level of moisture. pH sensor, it can also be used in greenhouse, chemical manufacturing, environmental monitoring and aquariums also. How basically the sensor works? First of all, it measures a physical quantity. For example, it is measuring the temperature or pressure or anything, just a physical quantity. It converts the value through analog to digital converter. It converts the value through analog to digital converter because computer cannot understand physical quantity. So then it sends the value to the microprocessor after converting to the digital form by using ADC. Microprocessor compares the value with the pre-recorded values, with the pre-recorded normal values. So it will compare. If it mismatches, like suppose it is less than or greater than the value, then it may do some control operations. If any action is necessary, then signals are sent to actuators through digital to analog converter. What are the advantages of sensors? Reading taken using sensors are more accurate. It can monitor information constantly. It can respond immediately. No need for the human to operate the sensors. It can be useful if gathering the information is hazardous. just like in the volcanoes. Okay, next input device is graphic tablet. Graphic tablets are used mainly by the professional graphic designers. Using a graphic tablet, a designer can produce much more accurate drawings on the screen you're using to draw it by your hand. A graphic tablet consists of a flat pad, the tablet, on which user draws with a special pen called a stylus. The pen that is used to draw on the graphic tablet known as a stylus. As the user draws on the pad, the image is created on the screen. The stylus that the user draws with may have the button on it, which will act like a mouse button. Then after editing, after drawing, you can convert that image to the editable form. By using them softwares, you can edit the image also. These are all the manual input devices. If you have any questions related to this, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you very much for listening.